Too bad this observatory's so busted up. I'd love to look at the stars.
Anything you need to know? Well, you aren't an initiate yet, but I guess we can discuss it a bit, since you helped out and all. I'd like to reverse engineer it and make more, of course. With the amount of energy it can unleash, we could power all kinds of things for a very long time. Think of how far a vertebrate could fly on ultrasight power. No, I don't think so. As much as I'd love to, we're too short-handed, and I just don't have that kind of expertise. We'll have to make do with learning what we can from the project for now. Sure thing. What's the next topic? I'll be here if you need anything.
Must be the one I've been hearing about. Paladin Layla Romani, what do you need? It takes more than hope to join the Brotherhood. Night Shin has spoken in your favor, but you'd also need Scribe Valdez's approval for me to consider your candidacy.
If I don't sleep tonight, I should be able to get this list done.
As a paladin, I am the commander of the First Expeditionary Force to Appalachia, and by extension, the ranking officer here at Fort Atlas.
Another nuke? You arrived in Appalachia not a moment too soon.
I've received a report from Night Shin detailing your assistance in his duties. He has given his approval to your consideration as an initiate. Word around the fort is that you've been working with Scribe Valdez as well. Well, between this and the report I have from Night Shin, we can discuss you becoming a member of our order. Consider it carefully. Do you wish to join our ranks? Membership in the Brotherhood is a commitment to honor, duty, and service. You would begin as an initiate in our ranks. With time and training, you may one day join the Scrolls as a knight or scribe, depending on your aptitudes and choices. On a day-to-day basis, Night Shin would be your direct superior here, though any of the officers may requisition you for missions if needed. Both have given their approval to your initiate consideration. Yes. Night Shin said that your attitude regarding the role of the Brotherhood in relation to the civilian community was questionable. Nonetheless, he felt your intentions were honorable, and suitable training would correct any deficiencies. Which means he probably thought I'd like you. That remains to be seen. In short, she thinks you are capable, helpful, and possessed of a higher than average technical aptitude. Useful qualities in an initiate candidate. Yes. I know we can seem cold to outsiders, so I'll let that pass. What I want you to understand is that we are committed to helping the people of Appalachia. We want to aid in the restoration of civilization, and you could be a part of that. Consider it. With the recommendations of Knight Shin and Scribe Valdez, I'm willing to consider you for membership. But first, I need to see how you handle yourself without direct supervision. In order to be effective in our operations here, we need to establish positive relations with the people of Appalachia. If we make them see us as a beneficial presence in the area, it will be much easier to secure cooperation in the future. We have reports of feral ghoul attacks on traders and travelers in the Southwest Forest region, indicative of a nest of some kind. I want you to clear it out. Your reward is that I consider you worthy to join our ranks. Limited intel suggests this is a milk run, perfect for a new recruit. But you're not wrong. We don't know the level of threat. Take this as an additional precaution.
Another nuke. You arrived in Appalachia not a moment too soon.
Complete this mission satisfactorily, and I will grant you initiate status within the Brotherhood. Yes. While I'm not in the habit of explaining my priorities to would-be recruits, you may have noticed there's a lot of work to be done here. You doing it accomplishes the mission and adds another member to our ranks. Two birds, one stone. We don't know. Our initial reports on the attacks came from a family of farmers, the Putnams, that we passed on the way into the region. I think their sons were rather starstruck when we showed up. I almost expected the older boy to follow us when we left. You should start your search there. They may know more. You can find them at the old Lewis and Sons farming supply. Well, do this, and you will be one of us, with all the rights and responsibilities of a full member of the Brotherhood of Steel. Ad Victoriam.
Each day in service of the Brotherhood.
these new initiates. I may need another scribe just to keep the scrolls up to date.
Keep fighting out there. Greetings, civilian. Find, protect, and preserve. I have my eye on you.
Brotherhood's always looking for good tech.
Thank you. Ad Victoria. Fort Atlas is in good hands. Knight Shin's trained us well.
Are you buying this keep the peace idea these Brotherhood types are putting down?
Thank you. Yourself some gross meat-covered explosives, but now what? Well, use your imagination. The trapper sure did. Any hungry carnivore is sure to be drawn in by the smell of fresh meat. So this one time, Chuck, he was the guy who came up with this crazy idea. He laid out explosive bait along the trail after a raid. Then, when the responders came looking for us with their tracking dogs, well, let's just say the hounds lost their scent. You know, because their heads were blown off. Whatever, you get what I'm saying. I don't care what you use your bait on. Just use it to kill some things that would kill and eat you. Let me know how it works for you. Up their dignity and couldn't bear to commit unprovoked violence. I don't know much about their special tactics. Did they have any? I don't know. Go find a Deathclaw and make friends with it or something.